Hello everyone, this is Robert with SparkFun Electronics, and welcome to our Intro to Robotics video. In the past, we've typically only carried electronics, prototyping boards, and things of that nature. We really haven't carried all the components you need to build your robot. Well, we're looking to change that. We're very proud to introduce the Actobotics product line, where we will be carrying 500 additional robotic components strictly for robotics. So now you can have the electronics and the robotic components all in one place, and you don't have to go shopping around for everything. This is the first of the 9-part video series where we explain all the different components that go into building a robot. We're going to talk about belts, pulleys, gears, bearings, and all the other things that you need to know to build your very own robotic creation. Before we get into that, let's first talk about what is robotics.
Robots are electromechanical systems designed typically to help people with tedious, repetitive, and sometimes dangerous tasks. Robots are comprised of actuators being motors or servos, and sensors being user inputs or electronic sensors. Robots are all around us, from the dishwasher in our kitchen to the robot vacuum cleaners cleaning our floors. We even have robots on Mars. Robots are essential to manufacturing, with the use of automated welders to build our cars, to CNC machinery to build our circuit boards. While robots may be useful, they're sometimes difficult to design and build. There's motors, there's sensors, there's computers, and interfacing all these together is quite a challenge, crossing many disciplines. Through this video series, we're going to try to give you some shortcuts in understanding some of these different disciplines.
So when building a robot, there's a lot of different parts and pieces that you're going to need. You're going to need anything from shafts to wheels to gears to motors. The one thing that we really like about Actobotics is all the parts work together. They have common hole spacing. They've either got a 0.77 inch or a 1.5 inch that all the parts use, so they easily mate together and you can use these in any different configuration. And you don't have to worry about re-drilling or tapping a hole. It all just works together nicely. So be sure to join us next week for the next installment of our robotic video series, which will be angular motion. We're going to be talking about wheels, bearings, shafts, and also all the different types of motors that you could be using. So, see you then.